Yahushua HaMashiach's birth on this earth was during the season of Sukkot.
And Yahweh spoke to Moses, saying, Speak to the people of Israel, saying, On the 15th day of this 7th month, and for 7 days, is Chag Sukkot, the Feast of Booths. On the 1st day shall be a solemn rest, and on the 8th day shall be a solemn rest. You shall celebrate it as a feast to Yahweh, it is a statute forever. You shall dwell in Sukkot, booths, for 7 days, that your generations may know that I made the people of Israel dwell in booths, temporary shelters, when I brought them out of the land of Egypt. I am Yahweh your God. Leviticus 23.
In the temple courts, Yahushua kept both Sukkot and Hanukkah according to the New Testament, John chapter 7 and 10.
Shout it out loud and shout it out clear.
We in AmightyWind Ministry are here, and we're putting our Sukkot right back up.
For Hanukkah, and we don't care what anybody thinks. Besides the miracle of lights, the book of 2 Maccabees tells us the origin of Hanukkah is the autumn festival of Sukkot, except celebrated later in the winter.
Now Judah Maccabee and his company, Yahweh guiding them, recovered the temple and the city, but the altars which the heathen had built they pulled down, and having cleansed the temple, offered a sacrifice after 2 years, and set forth incense and lights and showbread. And they kept the 8 days with gladness, as in the Feast of Tabernacles, remembering that not long afore they had held the Feast of Tabernacles, as they wandered in the mountains and dens like beasts. Therefore they bare branches and fair boughs, and palms also. They ordained every year those days should be kept of the whole nation of the Jews. 2 Maccabees 10. See that ye keep the Feast of Tabernacles in the month of Kislev. 2 Maccabees 1 verse 9.
So we're going to do it.
And anyone who'd like to join, you're welcome to. Do you want to see Apostle Elisheva's personal sukkah? You're invited inside.
Ani ohevet.
Asa Mikaiyah.
Is Hebrew for I love.
Asa Mikaiyah.
Shalom, AmightyWind congregation. And all those who are visitors who worship ABBA YAHUVEH, YAHUSHUA, and the RUACH KODESH, the ONLY HOLY TRINITY, which are three in one. I want to invite you to my Sukkah. All of you, these are my own personal possessions that are used on Shabbat and on these holy days. I share with you something I have never shared before on this special Sukkot of 2019. With much love, Apostle Prophet Elisheva Eliyahu, in the love of Yahushua, I invite you into the Sukkah. Yahushua gave me a word, and it was in my sleep, and I was praying, and I woke up with it, and he said, for everyone who is sending in these videos of their way that they are celebrating Sukkot and the birth of Yahushua HaMashiach on this earth, that I will be there. A layer of my soul is with my beloved ones who have sent in these videos. I'm sorry I could not open it up to all of AmightyWind congregation, but it would take a year. And we only have these days, and I'm already getting late with so many beautiful videos where you are going to see laughter and fun and dancing and singing. So come join with us. Come be in my sukkah. Let us dance together. Let us show the celebration of the birth on this earth of the only king of Israel. The only Messiah, the only way, the truth, and the life to heaven. Hallelujah! Happy Sukkot! And happy Happy birthday, Yahushua HaMashiach. We worship, we love, and we adore you. And all Almighty Wing congregation, you are so faithful and so loving and supportive. I love you so much, and I look forward to meeting you in heaven. Yahushua HaMashiach bless you. Shalom. Amen.
Vesamachta dechagecha, ve'ayita ach sameach. Thou shalt rejoice in thy festival, and thou shalt only rejoice. Deuteronomy 16. When you have gathered in the produce of the land, you shall celebrate the feast of Yahuveh 7 days. On the first day shall be a solemn rest, and on the eighth. And you shall take the fruit of splendid trees, branches of palm trees, and boughs of leafy trees, and willows of the brook, and you shall rejoice before Yahuveh your God. Leviticus 23.
Shalom, beloved Almighty Wind congregation. Ani ohevet is Hebrew for I love you. And we worship and we love and we adore you with our mind, body, spirit, and soul. All the co-creators of the who are the holy three Trinity, Abba Yahuveh, Yahushua, and the RUACH KODESH. The bride and the groom on this table represents the bride of Yahushua HaMashiach. Oh, we look forward to being the bride. We look forward to the words that you spoke in the prophecies. We will be dancing the Jewish dances with you at the marriage supper of the Lamb, beloved Yahushua. You will dance with each one of your bride. You will dance with each one of the guests. Well, you must have witnesses. Not all can be the bride. And they all are welcome. And the scripture says, blessed are all who are invited to the marriage supper of the Lamb. You can see my anointing vials of oil on this table. You can see on top of a special jewelry box, a mirrored one that holds my precious jewelry that is holy, my own personal prayer shawl. You can see the I love you, the golden heart. And that now symbolizes I love you to the Gan, our beloved Abba Yahuveh, Yahushua, and the Ruach HaKodesh, the Holy Trinity. Hallelujah! Once again, happy Sukkot! Ani ohevet, beloved Yahushua HaMashiach. Happy birthday! We celebrate Sukkot, and we acknowledge that you were born on the first day, and we celebrate it for 8 days. On the eighth day is when you were circumcised. Yahushua, we worship you. Amen.
Prophet Elisheva Eliyahu's own sukkah with her own personal possessions is publicly shown in this video.
Since she's the leader of AmightyWind ministry, sharing it with all of the AmightyWind congregation.
And all who are blessed by AmightyWind ministry, by the holy prophecies, and by her.
And accept them as a blessing from the Holy Trinity, Abba Yahuveh, Yahushua HaMashiach, and the precious Ruach HaKodesh.
This picture that you see is the one and only original oil painting that I had seen in a vision. Yahushua's tears of blood, he weeps. He weeps for Israel. He weeps for those who say that they are his. And yet he will say to them, "Depart from me, you workers of iniquity, for I have never known you." He weeps for what must be done in the great tribulation. He weeps tears of blood. And you see the holy angels, Archangel Michael, he's coming up there with his sword to war. Do you see the picture behind that? Everything there I saw in a vision, and even the clock there, oh, it's seconds before the midnight hour. Yahushua comes in the midnight hour, and let no one tell you that it'll be on a certain date. For Yahushua himself, the Father has not told him yet when to go get the bride. We know the time, we know the season, because that was in a prophecy, and even the Jews know, and they celebrate Rosh Hashanah. And Rosh Hashanah is the date of creation. Get to know the holy feasts. But beware. Stay away from anything other than the biblical scriptures. Stay away. Unless you know those so-called lost books are truly backed up with scripture. And you can trust the ones that are at AmightyWind.com, for I have read them. And you can trust Enoch 1 and Enoch 2. But Enoch 3 is straight from the devil. Do not believe a word in the book that is commonly called Enoch 3. Do not allow anyone to teach it to you. And never think that you are a god. We are who are saved by the name and the blood of Yahushua. The Bible says we are scarcely saved. And what chance does anyone have who does not have the blood of Yahushua washing them clean with his holy, pure blood sacrifice that Abba Yahuveh called the perfect sacrificial lamb? For without the shedding of blood, there can be no remission of sin. Oh Israel, where is your blood sacrifice? That's in a prophecy. Oh Israel, the one who will come and sit in that third temple will be the son of Satan. Take a warning. Take a warning now, people. Never accept the mark of the beast. Yahushua weeps. He weeps for all of the cowards who will do so. But your names were not found written in the Lamb's Book of Life. For Yahushua says you cannot lose one. He will leave the 99 righteous ones following his commands, worshiping him, to go and look for that little lost black lamb that wandered away. You keep on wandering into the pasture of the devil. You keep on going to the wolves' den. And now you dare call yourself a god? This is Kabbalah now I'm talking about. Beware, beware of this dark mysticism. Beware of anyone who's sitting telling you there's any other god than the Holy Trinity that I have just named. This is in the Holy Scriptures. This is in the Tanakh. This is in the Torah. And of course, it's in the New Testament. It's all through the Holy Scriptures. Oh people, I know millions have come to Yahushua because he told me to give birth to this ministry online over 25 years ago, but this is the first time I have ever invited you into my sukkah. This is the first time that we have ever done anything like sharing the videos we are sharing of members of this congregation that I trust and love. This is the first time that I've shown my own personal most treasured items on this earth is found on these tables you see here. Nothing else can compare to what you see on those tables. For even the anointing oil is there. Everything. Everything that is needed is a reminder of who Yahushua HaMashiach is. I'm the ohevet. I'm the ohevet. To all who receive this ministry and me and those who help me labor in this harvest field to bring souls to Yahushua so we can meet each other in heaven. More than that, it's for the salvation of your soul. But just remember, to those who get to heaven, shout out my name. I'll come running, and I'll give you the biggest hug, and we will rejoice. We will rejoice, for the work on earth was finally done. And we will rejoice for all eternity with the price Yahushua HaMashiach gave with his own life. He was tortured in our place. He was crucified in our place. And Yahushua gave me a revelation that's in a prophecy soon to come. And in those 3 hours that he suffered so greatly and he was mocked and spit upon, and vinegar was offered to his lips when he thirsted, he's seen every name like a flash that I can't even describe, for only God himself could do that. Only Yahushua himself could do that. But every name written in the Lamb's Book of Life. This blood's for you. This blood's for you. This blood's for you. And for everyone who rejects it, he's seen you in the book of the damned and in the book of the blotted out, knowing not even the sacrifice that he gives would be appreciated. Instead, his name would be damned, or they would call themselves a god, or they would deny Yahushua and only use him as for a curse word. That picture right there, 1 minute to midnight, Yahushua weeps tears of blood, like he did in the Garden of Gethsemane. Do you remember that? That's what this picture represents. When you see a copy of it on my reprobate enemies' wall of shame, and you see it on their websites or on their YouTube channel, they do not have my permission to use a picture of Yahushua They do not have my picture, my permission to use the 1 minute to midnight painting. This shows that the devil comes to steal, kill, and destroy. And when you see that picture, if they are not part of a Mighty Wind ministry and they are my enemy and the enemy of all that is holy, and only the holy are part of a Mighty Wind ministry, you will know that they are a deceiver. They are a deceiver. They are trying to appear like they are holy and they are not. You already could go to the reprobate's wall of shame and just know this. They're doing just what I said, to confuse the sheep and the lambs. Oh, I saw that picture before. Oh, that these people, they must be Christian. Well, they once had diaper salvation, but it wasn't good enough. They gave their lives to Satan, and they gave their souls to Satan. And the proof of it is on the reprobate's wall of shame. And again, YAHUSHUA himself said, people only want to teach about his love, his mercy, his forgiveness, his healing power, resurrection power, forgiving power. But everyone wants to forget. He warned more about hell than he spoke about heaven. And how many want to remember? Beware of the wrath of the Lamb. He stomps on the grapes underneath his feet. And only recently, in a prophecy not even released, he told me those are the rotten fruit, the rotten grapes. Those who once tasted the goodness in Hebrews 6, and now they call themselves a god. This is like re-crucifying YAHUSHUA all over again. You cannot bring a reprobate back to repentance. With their words, with their mouth, they may speak that which is scripture, but their hearts do not belong to YAHUSHUA. I had to say all of this because when you look at that picture, you see those little angels there? There's little angels there too. There's all different kinds of angels in heaven. But Archangel Michael is the main one that protects Israel. And the main one that I have seen physically touch the wing, which is in another testimony in 2005 of Archangel Michael. He protects this ministry. He wars against the enemies of this ministry. And YAHUSHUA is the one who sends him. This is why Israel will always be there. And even a new Jerusalem that will come forth out of heaven will be in Israel. Oh, Israel. There is a warning. The great tribulation is coming. It's you who will build that third temple, and you who will allow the son of Satan to sit on that throne until he does an abomination that even you will hide your face in shame. I know what that abomination of abomination is. Again, it's in a prophecy, not yet released, because I'm so backed up in prophecies. But praise YAHUSHUA, it will be released in his timing. So again, when you see this picture, if you don't know that they are part of a Mighty Wind ministry, then realize this, they are of the devil, out to deceive you. And that goes for that picture of Emiah also. You see, that's the vision I had. I want to show that to you now. up close, and that's the cover of the book. I sat at the banquet table already, and it was a dream that was oh so much more than a dream. It was an open vision. Oh, people, please read the prophecies. See, they do line up with the word of ABBA YAHUVEH, YAHUSHUA, because it's written underneath the anointing of the RUACH HaKODESH. YAHUSHUA bless you. Again, I say welcome to my Sukkah. I've taken the time to explain everything. These are my most treasured possessions. The only thing I left off, because I did not have a room to put it on the table right now, is, and I always have it in my hands, and that is my Messianic Jewish Bible. I prefer the Holy Roots Messianic Jewish, for they have the names, the two sacred names of the Holy Trinity in it. So that's the one thing missing on the table that I regret not putting in this video. But we don't have time to redo it, and I didn't even know I was going to speak to this. My love for souls is so great. We have haters, and we must know that we are going to be persecuted. But it's not even we. Those who belong, who are blood worshipped, blood bought with the blood of Yahushua HaMashiach. It's not even us, the person that is hated. For my worst reprobate serpent enemies, they're of Satan. Yahushua warned. He warned the scribes and the Pharisees. Oh, people, beware of the demon of a Pharisee. Beware. For their words are just nothing more than the letter killeth. But they don't have the RUACH HaKODESH to bring life to it. Beware of the demon of a Pharisee. Beware of the demon of idolatry. Beware of anyone who teaches you there's more than three in the Godhead, who are the three. They are the co-creators, and I've named them already. It's ABBA YAHUVEH, YAHUSHUA MASHIACH, and the RUACH HaKODESH. Whoa, whoa, whoa! To anyone who changes it. If there's a chance for them, and they know that they're not reprobate, better repent. They're one toe away from hell. This is a demon goddess that is trying to defile the Holy Trinity. You even hear the name Urea. It's a component of urine. And a new prophecy given to me today on this Sukkot, October 19th, 2019. The devil was a demon goddess who speaks out of someone who was once born of a female. You hear anyone say the name Urea, remember that's a component of urine. And Satan is mocking the living water of the RUACH HaKODESH that says that it flows from our belly right out of our mouths. People, this is a demon goddess. Be beware of anyone who leads you to worship any other god. Tell me, what's he already in? What we call the Bible. The Hebrews are not the one who did this. It is Satanists who brought up this demon goddess. Woe be unto those if they die and they do not repent this lie. It all started with one woman. She says she speaks for her. And she calls death on me and says I blaspheme because I call her the goddess of urine. Almighty Wind congregation, you male Goliath slayers especially, please come slay these Goliaths with me through our prayers. Join with the women. You men, join us. Let us be Goliath slayers together. For Goliath was no ordinary mere man, but he was a hybrid, which is the fallen angel joined with a human body and a cannibal. And that's why the soldiers didn't come back. Oh, people, read and study and meditate on the Holy Bible. There's not one thing that's been left out. And then read Book of Enoch 1 and Enoch 2. Because you will see, for those who are spiritually mature, he was prophesying already where we're living at right now, in these end times. But hallelujah! He prophesied, YAHUSHUA is coming for his bride. Oh, hallelujah. That's all I have to say. I don't know about you, but I'm counting down the days, and we're one more day closer to heaven. One more day being wrapped in his arms. I have seen YAHUSHUA face to face, and my testimony is already on this, in this ministry. I'm telling you, he is real. I will stand before the thrones one day, and you will know that what I speak is the truth. The picture of him with the blue eyes that I now use in my animations and in the picture with YAHUSHUA, my true, soon coming bridegroom, who I call already my spiritual husband, YAHUSHUA Mashiach. So that's why you will see his picture always next to me, and his hands are on my shoulders, reminding me that in this ministry there will be haters, and the fallen angels will come at those who truly worship him and are the bride of YAHUSHUA. But there's always haters. It's nothing new. If Satan loves you, well, you're doomed for hell. So it's quite an honor to be hated and persecuted for YAHUSHUA's name's sake. For great are the rewards in heaven. And the prophets of old all suffered. And YAHUSHUA suffered in our place. Should we not be willing to suffer also for his name's sake? For holiness? Stand up for righteousness. For it is the prayers of the righteous that avails much. And the prayers and the curses that are sent my way, they avail nothing. For why stand, and we all who belong to YAHUSHUA stand on Luke 10:19. They're not even human anymore. Remember that. When you look in the face of a reprobate soul, somebody who actually knows what they're doing, even if you once thought they were saved, they no longer have the RUACH HaKODESH. They are damned. As Yahushua called them, you snakes, you serpents, you vipers. I am from above and you are from below and your father is the devil. That is because he recognized the fallen angels that had entered into the scribes and the Pharisees. As it was then, so it is now. There's no aliens coming from another planet. They're right here on Earth right now. And they have always been, ever since Lucifer and one-third of the fallen angels. Remember, those fallen angels once were holy. They are on this Earth. And they're looking for reprobate souls to go into, to guarantee them they're going to hell. There's no hope for them. But praise Yahushua. Praise Yahushua. It's not too late for those who are listening to my voice and who truly worship Yahushua. It's not too late, even for those who have been in Kabbalah, who have done the sins and who have accepted the lies of the third eye. And beware of the vibrations in music now as they're out to drive you insane and make you think that which is going to be called the anti-Messiah, the Antichrist. You won't think that it is God, but not those who belong to Yahushua. You will know. You will know the truth. And you will be willing to become a martyr if need be, because you will know Yahushua HaMashiach is the only Messiah. And your next breath will be heaven if you are martyred. So forgive me, I'm just a frustrated preacher who needed to preach all because I saw the picture of 1 minute to midnight. This picture is an oil painting. It has always been with me for oh so many years. It is an actual vision I had on a phone, just praying on the telephone. It was an open vision. Yahushua HaMashiach bless all those who worship Yahushua HaMashiach in spirit and in truth, and strive to obey him, and who repent of their sins, not just in words, but in actions. Shalom. Happy Sukkot, and happy birthday, beloved Yahushua, when you were birthed on this earth during this time of Sukkot. And this is also called the Festival of Booths. And I want to explain to you, as they put up that temporary tabernacle in the Old Testament, the Old Blood Covenant, as I said, it was just a shadow of what would happen when Yahushua said it is finished. These bodies of ours are the temporary tabernacles right now. And they're waiting to put on those glorified spiritual bodies. Do you understand? When you read the Old Blood Covenant, remember Yahushua said he did not come to cancel the laws of the prophets. He came to fulfill them. He came to say, I've given you a better way. And he said, it is finished. And when he said it is finished, it was finished. There is no more sacrifices. There is no more burnt offerings that will please Yahweh. For Moshe warned of that. Moses warned. That's Moshe's name. He warned. Yahweh said no more animal sacrifices would be covering of any sins. And Moshe warned. There was a new blood covenant coming to wash the sins away. And it is Yahushua, the highest of the high priest in the order of Melchizedek, because he is and he was Melchizedek. And don't let anyone else tell you different. Please, people, study and show yourself approved. Stay humble and walk in humility. And pray you will not be deceived. For those we once thought we could trust, we can't anymore. They've gone astray. They call a demon goddess, Uriah. Can you imagine? Do you know what's going to happen if they continue to believe that lie? To mock the Ruach HaKodesh, Holy Spirit, with the name Yaron, and say that's your daughter in heaven, Yahushua's sister. That's who's hanging on the reprobate's wall of shame, and every name is there, only more will be added. Those are the ones that Yahweh said will burst in a spontaneous combustion. Actually, channeling the demon goddess, Uriah. What I mocked, I no longer mock. Truly is a demon goddess. Come out of the mysticism. Come out of the sorcery. Repent. Yahushua weeps tears of blood for you. If you are not a reprobate serpent, there's still hope for you. Shalom. I just want to add, since I'm showing you my own personal beautiful table that is reserved for the Shabbat and the holy articles that I have on it, this table literally sparkles. And Yahushua said, right now his bride sparkles on this earth. And it's buried amongst dung right now on this earth. And they are called reprobates and fallen angels are entering into the reprobates. But the bride of Yahushua still sparkles. And heaven can see each and every one who prays, O Abba Yahuveh, in Yahushua's name, please make me count me worthy to be called your bride, the bride of Yahushua. He's coming. He's coming closer. The more evil this world has become, the more that you see fall on the left and on the right, just like Psalm 91 says, though 1,000 fall on my left and 1,000 fall on my right. This was not just about the plagues. This is a great falling away that has already begun. Those you thought would never fall away. Those you thought were even leaders of ministries that you could trust. Once was even called a co-leader. You see them fall away. You wonder what is happening. Well, Yahushua gave me the answer. You see, we can't blame it all on the devil no more. This is Yahushua's time when he said that he is already dividing those who are holy unto him in spirit and in truth and obedience to Yahushua and to the lukewarm Christians and to the Satanists pretending to be Christians. He is dividing right now. He is dividing the wheat from the tares. He is dividing the sheep from the goats. He is dividing with his own hand. Whether it be a mother and a father, a husband and a wife, a sister and a brother, it hurts us when we see those that we once called our beloved ones become traitors and serve Satan, and especially when they call on another demon. That's called a demon goddess, and they dare to add it to the Holy Trinity. Woe be unto you who have done this. If you are not reprobate, get in the arms of Yahushua now, before the great tribulation starts. For the bride of Yahushua will be spared that time, just like in Revelations, the Church of Philadelphia has promised. Thank you. Thank you for coming to my sukkah, which I open up now as the Almighty Wind, the Aleph and the Tav, the Rakha Kodesh, Holy Fire Ministry. Affectionately, Yahushua calls the Mighty Wind Ministry. With the Mighty Wind that comes rushing in each and every Sukkah who truly worship and adore and exalt the majesties, King of Kings and Lord of Lords. He's coming again. Are you ready? Will it be another Sukkot we have to wait? This is the time that we celebrate. Not like in the old blood covenant. That's not why we're doing it. That was just history. That is a foreshadow of who Yahushua is, when he was going to be birthed. Remember, when you read the old blood covenant, it is history, it's a foreshadow of everything Yahushua did for us as a perfect blood atonement for sin. For no one that ever walked this earth was perfect in the form of a human except for one, and it was Yahushua HaMashiach. Everyone needs to repent, for none of us are perfect. But those who belong to Yahushua HaMashiach, they will not premeditate sin. They fear the Ruach HaKodesh, who some call the Holy Spirit, because you do not want to blaspheme the Holy Spirit, the Ruach HaKodesh, Shekinah glory. If she leaves your soul, you are damned. Do you hear me? You are reprobate. And we already have the wall of shame for the reprobates who once had died for salvation. But this is a celebration. And what I have to say is, woe be unto those that fall under he who sits on the throne and the wrath of the Lamb, which is a warning in Revelation 6. Please, people, repent. I am a Jew, but I wasn't born in Israel. So I'm of the tribe of Ephraim, and I wait for my Judah to come to join with Ephraim again. I don't know where he is, but I do know this. Yahushua did not start a good work and not finish it. We are sent to Israel. The Ruach HaKodesh books, Secrets of the Ruach HaKodesh, took 7 years to put together all the proof of who Eve was made in the image of. And the Jews already had that knowledge. They already have it. They already know the Ruach HaKodesh. Even the name is feminine gender. They already know. But it took someone like me for Prophecy 89 and 90 to go out on that shaken limb who did not know whose image Eve was made in until that prophecy. Oh, my beloved, a Mighty Wind congregation, and you visitors, come and watch us celebrate how we honor our Messiah, the one and the only. And woe be unto Israel if you don't accept the one whose blood is still drenching your soil that now goes around the world. And to everyone who acknowledges and says, please forgive me, Yahushua, of my sins. Wash me clean with your blood. I repent of the evil that I've done and I confess my sins to you. Thank you for forgiving me. Thank you for taking those sins and putting them as far as the east is from the west. Thank you for putting your Ruach HaKodesh inside of my soul. Thank you. Like the prayer that David said, the Ruach HaKodesh. Please never leave my soul. This is his prayer. This should be everyone's prayer. That the anointing of the Ruach HaKodesh, the Holy Spirit, only gets stronger in you each and every day. People, please realize. Israel, wake up. The Messiah. Blood is still in your soil. He was born a Jew from a Jewish virgin woman. The miracles that take place that are recorded happened in Israel. Oh Israel, we love you. Oh Israel, come back. Come back. Yahweh has promised to remarry you. Come back in the name of Yahushua Mashiach. The Shema is still the one true God. But there are three. Yahweh, Yahushua Mashiach, the only begotten Son of Yahweh, and the Ruach HaKodesh, sweet Holy Spirit. When you see the celebration, it doesn't matter whether or not you've known this before. I speak to the Hebrews all over the world. It's not too late. Come into the arms of Yahushua. And look forward to our next coming videos. Because next is going to be Hanukkah, which we call the Festival of Lights, because Yahushua is the eternal light. That was when Yahushua was conceived. We celebrate Hanukkah. Yes, I know. The Old Blood Covenant says it was for the rededication of the temple and for the temple was defiled. Dead bodies laid all around it. And there was not enough oil to be able to light the lanterns, the menorah. There was a miracle that happened. And once again, it happened in Israel. But it was history. It was a shadow to come of Yahushua HaMashiach, the eternal light that will never go out. And when you have the Ruach HaKodesh inside of you, you have an anointing inside of you, an eternal light that will never go out as long as you prove that you have accepted Yahushua as Mashiach, as Messiah's Savior, whatever name you want to call him. He loved us so much. He said, if there had only been one, everyone whose name is written in the Lamb's Book of Life could only come in the name of Yahushua HaMashiach, also called Jesus Christ. He should be the love of your soul, for he is a lover of your soul. You should be celebrating. And woe unto you, mainline Christian churches, for I was first saved in a Pentecostal church. You don't even teach the Jewish feasts. You don't even tell the people that it's your birthday, and it's not December 25th. Come out of agreement with Satan, mainline organized churches. Line up with the true holy scriptures. He is the King of Israel. And they could not take that, those words that were above that cross he was crucified on. But hallelujah, on the third day, after he said it is finished, he rose again, he was resurrected, came out of that tomb. And we know this, for those who have died and those who belong to Yahushua, to be absent from the body is to be present with the Lord, Yahushua HaMashiach. Stand on the new blood covenant scriptures called the New Testament. Read the old blood covenant, the Old Testament. But see that Yahushua is there everywhere from Genesis to Revelation. And do not believe any other doctrines. For they can be doctrines of the devils. And there's so many out there right now. Do not believe that there's more than the Holy Three co-creators. Heavenly Father, His Son, Yahushua HaMashiach, the Holy Spirit, the Ruach HaKodesh. Please, if you want to go to heaven, you truly love Yahushua. Scripture says that Yahushua said, why do you call me Lord and not obey me? Another version says, how can you say you love me and not obey me? If he's really the God of your life, you will, with all your mind, body, spirit, and soul, want to have a testimony like unto Enoch and be found pleasing Yahweh. For he did not die. His body was translated into a glorified body. For flesh and blood cannot enter into the kingdom of heaven. It was not created for flesh and blood. It was created for our spirit bodies that are oh so beautiful. People, there is no way to heaven except through the name and the blood of Yahushua. That's why we say, Happy Sukkot, happy birthday, our beloved on me, ohevet, we worship you, we worship you, we worship you, Yahushua HaMashiach. All of us celebrate. All of us celebrate. And to a mighty wind congregation and those who visit, come back and see for yourself and taste and see the fruit of this ministry is good, for you will never hear anything that doesn't line up with the Holy Scriptures. Shalom.
Please check out last year's Hanukkah video to hear the word that Prophet Elisheva received at the end of Sukkot 2019 about how there would be no birth of Yahushua HaMashiach without his conception. The link is in the description. This salvation prayer was given by Yahweh, Yahushua, and the precious Ruach HaKodesh to Apostle Elisheva Eliyahu 25 years ago. This emotional prayer has never been redone until now. Especially if you are not saved yet and haven't given your life to Yahushua, or if you have backslidden into sin, we urge you, and more than urge you, to say this salvation prayer together with her. If necessary, listen to it several times and get this prayer into your spirit. And again, repeat it with Elisheva Eliyahu with all of your heart and with all of your soul. and get saved, because tomorrow could be too late. Get saved and give your life to Yahushua HaMashiach right now.
Dearest beloved Yahushua HaMashiach, I give my life to you now. I ask that you live through me. I ask that you create in me a pure heart. Psalm 51. I accept you, Yahushua HaMashiach, now as a ruler of my life and my Messiah and Savior. You are the God that I worship and love. I need and I want and I desire. Forgive me for my sins, for I know all have sinned and fell short of the glory of our creators. Forgive me, Yahushua. Wash me clean. Wash me clean. I confess my sins before you now. I lay them at the foot of the cross of Calvary, where you were crucified and tortured and where you died in 3 hours. Later you said it is finished. And yet you didn't stay dead. On the third day you did arise before witnesses. And for 40 days you walked this earth until you ascended back to heaven before witnesses. Yahushua HaMashiach, whom some call Jesus Christ, I declare your Hebrew name now before the great tribulation comes. The name is used as a curse word when they say Jesus Christ, and they do not dare to say that as a curse word of Muhammad or Allah or Buddha or even Satan, but they curse the name above all names, one of the parts of the Holy Trinity, for you are the only begotten Son of Abba YAHUVEH and the Ruach HaKodesh. And you are the Holy Trinity, and there is no other. You are the co-creators. You are the Word that was made flesh. Oh, Yahushua, forgive me. Yahushua HaMashiach, the Messiah. Above that cross hung the words, King of Israel, and they couldn't take it down because you are coming back again to rule and reign. And oh, Yahushua, the bride of Yahushua, say, come, Yahushua, come. But not everyone is fit to be the bride of Yahushua. And so you say in the book of Revelation, blessed are all who are invited to the marriage supper of the Lamb. Oh, Yahushua HaMashiach, forgive me of my sins. Wash me clean. With the only pure, holy blood sacrifice. When you walked this earth for 33 years, you never had a thought of sin. You never had an action of sin. Although you were tempted with every sin, you told the devil to get lost. He had no claim on you. And he will have no claim on me after I say the salvation prayer. Oh, Yahushua HaMashiach, I believe you paid the price for my sins at Calvary. You were crucified. You were tortured. You were mocked. You were spit upon. Your clothes were stripped off of you. A soldier's gambled even for the clothes on your back. Oh, Yahushua HaMashiach, forgive me. And put your Ruach HaKodesh, the Holy Spirit, within me. So let me know when I do right and wrong. Send the Comforter. Let the Comforter come in me now. For I know you are not dead, but you arose again on that third day. As that big boulder was rolled away that the soldiers had placed there and guarded. But that did not stop you on that third day. The boulder rolled away. I ask you to come into my heart.
to forgive me of my sins. I confess every sin to you now, and I name them, and I turn away from them, because I've been washed clean of all the unrighteousness, all the filthiness of this world. I give my life and my love to you. I will not deny you. O Yahushua HaMashiach, you said if there had only been one, if there had only been me who would cry out for mercy, you would forgive and the sins would be as far as the east is from the west. You said there's only one sin that could not be forgiven, and that is a blasphemy of the RUACH KODESH, the sweet Holy Spirit. Oh, beloved Yahushua, I would not be saying this prayer now if I was someone who was of blasphemy, unless it was of mockery. And I do not mock. I truly believe with all of my heart, and I will not doubt, there is but one truth and way and life to get to heaven. There's only one intercessor, only one name that Abba YAHUVEH, the Holy Father, will even listen to a prayer, and that's through your name, Yahushua HaMashiach. I'm so sorry. I'm so sorry. I have sinned against you so greatly, but I rise up. I'm not staying fallen, and I rise up, and I come to you, and I hang on tight to the cross at Calvary, where you died for me, and where you said it was finished. I turn away from every sin. I rebuke Satan and all those who are part of him. I rebuke the unholiness in the name and the blood of Yahushua HaMashiach shall constantly be on my lips, and I shall study and show myself approved, and I shall read the New Testament. I shall read and I shall know you are the Torah, from the law, from the beginning to the end, from Genesis to Revelation. I thank you now for filling me with your Holy Spirit, the RUACH HaKODESH, the Mayah, the sweet, sweet Shekinah glory, the very presence of YAHUVEH. And thank you for giving me the desire to serve you all the days of my life. And thank you for giving me the desire to live your life in me. Oh, Yahushua, live your life through me. I give my life and my soul to you. My mind and my body belongs to you. I'm so grateful. I have a Messiah. There is a blood sacrifice, for as it is written, without the shedding of blood, there is no remission, no forgiveness for sin. And the blood of the animals that were sacrificed in the Old Testament, in the Old Blood Covenant, would not satisfy Abba YAHUVEH anymore, for the sin was so great. He had to send his only begotten Son, to whomsoever believeth in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. Thank you for filling me with faith to believe and never doubt. Oh, let your name be glorified through these lips and everything I do from now on. Show me how I can serve you. Show me how I can glorify you. Show me how I can exalt you. Thank you for freeing me from every addiction. Thank you for freeing me from every sin. And although I won't be perfect, thank you that I'm able to say and reach out to you again and say, Yahushua, I've fallen, please forgive me. But I will not premeditate sin. I will not hurt you like that, purposely. Thank you for giving me the desire to read the Bible, especially everything about you. Thank you for helping me to understand what Elisheva Eliyahu is teaching as a Messianic Jew. She's teaching the Hebrew roots of the biblical scriptures, and the Torah is from Genesis to Revelation. Your name is there. If they only knew Hebrew, they would see. As you told Elisheva Eliyahu, you taught her that the Torah, the Old Testament, was only a foreshadowing of when you would come. You would have a better plan. Moses did what he was to do, for at that time, it was not yet for you to be born. But even the blood that was over the doorpost of that sacrificial lamb was a foreshadow of you, Yahushua HaMashiach, when your blood would save and the angel of death would be forced not to touch those inside. And the curses could not come upon them, for they truly worshipped Abba YAHUVEH. Thank you for giving me the wisdom to understand the holy scriptures and the holy prophecies that you have spoken forth through a mighty wind ministry. Thank you for loving me and saving my soul. You said if it had only been me, you would have went to the cross at Calvary. You would have been tortured. You would have been beaten. And by your stripes, you said I was healed. You did not stop at your salvation, but you allowed Satan to go into the torturer that beat you 39 times with no ordinary whip, but a whip with bits of lead and stone and anything that could rip and tear your skin in shreds, till you barely even looked human, and then forced you to carry hundreds of pounds of a cross up the hill of Golgotha. Oh, Yahushua, help my faith to grow each day, O Yahushua HaMashiach, so one day I will be with you in heaven and you will embrace me and cover me in kisses. I will be at the marriage supper of the Lamb. I will not deny you, even when it comes to the fact that they say you have to lay your life down, like they will demand for people to become martyrs. And only the bride of Yahushua HaMashiach will have a testimony as unto Enoch. So help me to be strong in you. Fill me overflowing with the Ruach HaKodesh, Holy Spirit, now, and deliver me from the evil one called Satan. In your name, Yahushua HaMashiach, let the demons flee now in seven different directions. As I belong to you, Yahushua HaMashiach, as I say this prayer, and I pray it, and I will continue to pray it each and every day until it gets in my spirit and my soul and my mind and my body. Oh, Yahushua, help me, Yahushua, to remember all have sinned and fallen short of the glory of the Father, YAHUVEH. You came to save us sinners, and that's why you're called our Savior, our Mashiach. You are the one and the only way to heaven. Your name is salvation. Yah saves. It is not Yeshua. That takes away the divinity of your name. You're named after the Father. And the Father's name is in your name. This is what I've been taught to say. Help me, O Yahushua HaMashiach. Though none go with me, still I will follow. Help me, Yahushua HaMashiach, for I know I will be persecuted for your name's sake. Help me, Yahushua HaMashiach. I will never give up my faith in who you are. This day I am born again. I am blood washed. I am blood bought. My soul is not for sale. I belong to you, Yahushua HaMashiach. And because of it, I can now say to Satan, as it is written, submit yourself unto the name of Yahushua HaMashiach, and then resist the devil and he shall flee from me. And submit means I will obey you. I will obey the Ten Commandments. I will obey the holy feast that ABBA YAHUVEH has set in place to bring honor to the Holy Trinity. ABBA YAHUVEH, Yahusha HaMashiach, and the Ruach HaKodesh, sweet Holy Spirit. I will honor the Shabbat day and I will keep it holy. And it is not the lie of a Sunday. Help me, Heavenly Father, to defend the truth of AmightyWind ministry and the truths and the prophecies. Let me not turn into a reprobate enemy. Oh, Yahushua HaMashiach, I worship, I praise, I love, and I adore you. Thank you for coming into my heart. By faith, I believe every addiction has fled from me. Every temptation to sin right now is gone. And when I am tempted, remind me to call upon the name of Yahushua HaMashiach. I worship you. Oh, ABBA YAHUVEH, I've come now to the name of Yahushua HaMashiach, and I come before your throne and I ask for your help. For Yahushua has told me that before none could come to you and have a prayer answered unless it's through the name and the blood of Yahushua HaMashiach. I will read this prayer and I will hear this prayer, for it was spoken underneath the anointing, and Elisheva Eliyahu did not even know one word from the next what she would speak, for you put the new prayer in her mouth. For even the old prayer has passed away and become new. And I will say it not with the head knowledge, but with all of my heart. I believe it in faith. And I will remember that Yahushua HaMashiach is not only my God and my Lord and the soon coming King of Israel and the only begotten Son of YAHUVEH. He is my Messiah. He is my healer, my deliverer, my resurrector. And he is my best friend who will never leave me nor forsake me. Though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for he is with me. I hang on to Psalm 91 and I hang on to Psalm 23. For I know, Yahushua HaMashiach, you love me so much. You love me so much, you led me to where this prayer is. You love me just the way I am. You love me so much that you said, now I will make you better. Now I will raise up in you the true spirit within you so that I can say that you are pleasing unto me. I no longer call you a worker of sin. Yahushua, you paid the price for my sins. And now I don't need to feel guilty or condemned anymore. For I have confessed every filthy sin before you, Yahushua HaMashiach. I have named them and I have cried tears over them. And I have told you that I am so sorry. And you have said, my child, I forgive you. Now you must have faith, and faith is the substance of things hoped for, the evidence of things not yet seen. And even if I don't hear your voice like Prophet Elisheva Eliyahu, I know that you hear me. I know that you see me. I know that I am a child of ABBA YAHUVEH. You, YAHUSHUA HaMashiach, and you, precious RUACH HaKODESH, Holy Spirit, Imayah. All of my sins are now forgiven. And there's a no fishing sign there. The only one that can go there is if I choose to remember my past sins and feel dirty about them all over again. Or if I choose to allow Satan to go fishing there and say, remember what you used to be and do. And that's when you have told me, YAHUSHUA, that I am to tell Satan, I am forgiven. My soul belongs to YAHUSHUA HaMashiach. And as he reminds me of the past, I will remind him of the future, and that is a bottomless pit for eternity and the lake of fire. I now know that a sin is anything that I have done that displeases a holy ABBA YAHUVEH. And you, YAHUSHUA, and you, RUACH HaKODESH, I know that we all work out our own salvation with fear and trembling, and whatever was done in the war in heaven against Lucifer, the war has been brought down here on this earth. And I will fight him. I will fight Satan and all of the unholy ones with him and all of the reprobates. I will fight them. Not in my strength, not in my might, but in the anointing of the RUACH HaKODESH. I will get to know who you are, YAHUSHUA HaMashiach. For John 3:16, the Bible tells me that I must confess you as my ruler of my life, my Lord, my Savior, my Messiah. So you will confess me before the Holy Father, ABBA YAHUVEH. I must remember never to be ashamed of the name of YAHUSHUA HaMashiach. Never be ashamed of the truths and the revelations I will be taught. For YAHUSHUA HaMashiach is not ashamed of me. I will tell someone that I can trust that today I have made the decision of my life. This is my birthday, the day I say this prayer. With all of my mind, with all of my heart, my body and my soul belongs to YAHUSHUA. I accepted you, YAHUSHUA, of Calvary and Nazareth, born in Bethlehem, both God in the spirit and both God in the flesh. But it was flesh and spirit that hung on the cross at Calvary. And this day I know that all the angels in heaven are rejoicing. They are rejoicing and they're singing with joy. And if no one ever rejoices over me on this earth, if I feel no one ever loves me or accepts me for who I am, I know that you rejoice and I know that all the angels rejoice, for this is what the Bible says. And I know this apostle prophet, Pastor Elisheva Eliyahu, rejoices over me right now. And she has said, if I need a pastor, then I have one. And I know I am welcomed by a mighty wind that comes online ministry that is in 51 different languages around this world that call upon you. We are not alone. And they all tell me that I am welcome. And they all wait for me to write Elisheva Eliyahu and tell her, I've accepted you, YAHUSHUA HaMashiach. And even though I was an Orthodox Jew, And I speak now to those who will be Orthodox Jews. They too are welcome to come to Yahushua HaMashiach the way I've come to you this day. And oh, I look forward, Yahushua HaMashiach, for you embracing me and hugging me so tight and kissing my cheeks. I look forward at the marriage supper of the Lamb. Whether I be a bride or a guest, I will dance the Jewish dance with you. Oh, Yahushua, thank you for forgiving me. I feel so clean now. Thank you, Yahushua HaMashiach. Help me to grow quickly in you. Help me, give me more discernment. There's so many false prophets out there, so many who claim to be Christians, and yet they're lukewarm, that you're going to spit out of your mouth, vomit out of your mouth, as the book of Revelation says. Oh, Yahushua HaMashiach, bring another believer to me, so I will not walk this walk alone, but if I must, so be it. For I don't walk alone, I walk with you, my new best friend, my Messiah, my Lord God, my Savior. I have you, Yahushua HaMashiach. Thank you for the gift of eternal life that I just inherited this day. To know my name is written in the Lamb's Book of Life. Please keep it there and never let it be blotted out, is my prayer. And take not the Ruach HaKodesh, Holy Spirit, from me. Instead, increase the anointing within me. This is my prayer. I ask this day, on my true birthday, I said this salvation prayer. In Yahushua HaMashiach's name, I know that I will be hated more in this world than I am loved. Just like if you were walking this earth right now, they would hate you for your holiness. Thank you, Yahushua HaMashiach. For I know when Satan hates me and the demons and the reprobates hate me and they call me crazy, I know I truly belong to you, Yahushua HaMashiach, and I have been born again this day. Blood washed and blood bought, and my soul is no longer mine, but in your hand, Yahushua HaMashiach. Amen.
We're not gonna run, we're not gonna hide. Yahushua's coming back for his bride. We're YDS, we're standing strong. This is our song. The enemy said in 3 days she'll die, but Elisheva Eliyahu's alive. She's a YDS, still standing strong. This is our song. May 24, 2005, Archangel Michael fought to get to her side, fighting off the enemy. He protects the bride, his wing hanging over her bedside. Like an innocent 2-year-old child, she touched his wing, marveling at the beautiful sight. The Judases will run and hide. Reprobate enemies rejected, denied. Jeremiah 6, 27 to 30 is your eternal life. No pride in Yahushua HaMashiach's bride. Wanna be like Enoch, raptured into the sky. He was pleasing to ABBA YAHUVEH. He went to heaven alive. We're not gonna run, we're not gonna hide. Yahushua's coming back.